हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करजगी ऑर्किड चैनल। आई एम वीना टीचर टीचिंग यू फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड मैथ्स। यस, इन लास्ट सेशन व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड, यस वी हैव कंप्लीटेड ऑल द एग्जांपल्स फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 4.4। हैज आई टोल्ड यू, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट वन न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट, दैट इज डिवीजन बाय 10, 100 एंड 1000। ओके, you have studied this also in grade 3, but here in 4th standard it's a very interesting. Okay, you like it, I hope. Okay, because it is very easy. Now we have to observe the pattern. Now see, in the example 1, what we have to do, 186 division by 10, isn't it? Now see, they had given one hint. When a number is divided by 10, okay, when a number is divided by 10, remainder, the digit in the ones place. What remainder comes? Digit in the ones place. What is there? See, in this number, this is the ones place. So this will come as a remainder, and the quotient, what quotient will come? Made up by the rest of the digit. See, whatever rest of the digit, what are the rest of digit? Is 18. See, 18. See how easy it is, isn't it? Clear? See what they are saying. Whenever you are doing division by 10, so what remainder will come? The remainder will come the digit in the ones place, always only ones place. And what quotient will come? Whatever the numbers are remaining, it doesn't matter whether two numbers are remaining, 1, 3, 4, doesn't matter. So the last number at last means ones place number will remain as a remainder, and the quotient will come whatever number digits are remaining. See, now we will solve. 18 is not there in 10 table. What is less than that? 10 ones are 10. So 8 will remain, bring down 6. 10 8s are 18. Now 6 will remain. See, as I told you. So quotient is 18. Remainder is 6. Now this sum, what we will do, we will solve with our previous method only, and we will cross check with the given hint. Now 10 division by 12, so 2 digit, go with 2 digit only. Now this is 12. Now 12 is there in 10 table. 10 table is very easy, no need to write here. Okay, so 10 ones are 10, so 2 will remain, bring down 3. 10 twos are 20. 3 will remain, bring down 4. 10 3s are 30, 4 will remain. So what is your quotient? 123. What is your remainder? 4. But when I tell you this question with the given hint, what they said, when the question when the division is divided by 10, you have to write remainder ones place, the digit in the ones place. See, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, isn't it? So remainder will come ones place, and the quotient will come made up by the rest of the digit. What are the rest of digit? 123. See, directly you can write in this way also. See, we'll cross check. Correct, same, 123, remainder is 4. See, how interesting and very easy, na? Isn't it, students? Yes, very easy. So, by using this trick, you can solve this sum quickly, within a second, isn't it? But keep in your mind this hint, that when we divide any number by 10, the remainder is the digit in the ones place, and the remaining numbers will come in the rest digit will come as a quotient. Now see, what about hundreds? So hundreds also same. We will read the hint. When a number is divided by 100, remainder, what remainder will come? Made up by the digit in the tens and ones place. So this time what they are saying, ones and tens will come as a remainder, and the quotient made up by the rest of the digit. Whatever the digit is left, that will come as a quotient. See here. Now this example I'll write here. Okay, with the hint, what they had given hint? Okay, what they had given? First remainder. What is remainder when we divide with 100? Ones and tens will come as a remainder, and the quotient is the rest of the digit. What is the rest of the digit? Is 2. Now we will cross check with our division method. Now 100, see, you know the 100 table, same as it is like a 10 table. Otherwise you can go with the estimate also. 235 nearest is 200, 100 nearest is 100 only, isn't it? Cross 11, now 10. How many times 10 makes 20? 2 times, isn't it? So the estimate quotient is 2. Now try with actual number 200, isn't it? So 10, 100, 2s are 200. Now subtract 5, 3, 5 minus 0 is 5, 3 minus 0 is 3, 2 minus 2 is 0. Now see, what is the answer? Quotient is 2 and the remainder is 35. See, with the given trick also, we are getting the same answer. Got it? Now see the second example. Okay? See, you have to do the division, no doubt at all. But you can cross check whether these answers are correct or no very quickly. Now 4685 division by 100. Now first, see, when 3 digit division, go with 3 digit only. Now 3 digits are what? 468 nearest number is 500, and the 100 nearest is 100 only. Now cross 110, what is remaining? 10 and 50. How many times 10 makes 50? 5 times. Now we will try with actual number. 100 multiplied by 5, we get 500, but we cannot subtract 500 from this number, isn't it? 500 is greater. So we'll go with less than that, 4 quotient. So the answer is 400. So 100 multiplied by 4 is equals to 400. We can subtract. 8 minus 0 is 8, 6 minus 0 is 6, 4 minus 4 is 0. Now bring down the next number, that is 5, isn't it? Now 685. Now see, what is nearest? 700. Cross 1010, 10 and 7. So 7 times. But when we multiply 100 by 7, we get 700, isn't it? But is it greater than 685? So we'll go with one less number, 600. Okay, so 10 6 are 600, 5 minus 0 is 5, 8 minus 0 is 8, 6 minus 0 is 6. Okay, here now, as per given hint, how we can write this answer directly also? How we can write the quotient? First we will write the remainder. What is remainder when we are dividing with 100? The ones place and tens place is remainder always, that is 85. The rest remaining digit are quotient, that is 46. So if you know this answer, you can solve easily. Okay, I'll tell you how with the next example. Now see, read this given trick. When a number is divided by 1000, so what remainder will come? Remainder is made up by the digit in the hundreds, tens and ones place. See, for 100, tens, ones and tens. For 1000, 100, tens and ones. And what about quotient? Made up by the rest ones digit. Rest of the digit. Now I will explain you this question with the trick. You can solve fast. Okay, see what they said. Whenever you are dividing any number with 1000, ones, tens and 100 will be always remainder, and the quotient will be rest of the digit. What is the rest of digit? 3. So what you will do? So we got the quotient. Write quotient on the top directly. And what is the divisor? 1000 multiplied by 3 is 3000. So do directly. 1000 multiplied by 3 is 3000. Now do the subtraction. 5 minus 0 is 5. 6 minus 0 is 6. 5 minus 0 is 5. 3 minus 3 is 0. See, the answer is same. Understood? So this also I'll explain in that way. First, what we will do? With the given example, directly we will find out the quotient and remainder. First, remainder. So, remainder about division by 1000 will come ones, tens and 100. These three numbers. So, write remainder. And the rest of the digits are quotient. 48. We have written as it is. Okay. Now, see. Once we got quotient, write on the top quotient. Now go with the 4, 1000 4s are 4000. Do the subtraction. 9 minus 0 is 9, 6 minus 0 is 6, 8 minus 0 is 8. Whenever we subtract from any number 0, we get number itself. Okay. So to bring down the next number 3, again we are having already here, quotient is 8. So 8 times 1000 makes 8000. So write 8000 and do the subtraction. 3 minus 0 is 3, 9 minus 0 is 9, 6 minus 0 is 6, 8 minus 8 is 0. So in this way also the quotient is 48, the remainder is 693. Understood? Clear till here? Yes. Now we will start our exercise 4.5, that is find the quotient and the remainder. They had given some examples. We will solve one by one. But here they had given one hint. What is that hint? Applying the rules, dividend is the remainder. What is the quotient? Okay. We have to apply the rules of dividend is the remainder. So what is the quotient? Okay, we will solve one by one. Exercise 4.5. From that first one, I'll take 683 division by. Now see how we can write this number. Dividend and write divisor the left side, isn't it? Now we have to, what they had given a hint here, dividend is the remainder. So what is the quotient? See, just now we have studied about division by 10, 100 and 1000, isn't it? Now here what I'll do, we will write quotient and the remainder. See, whenever you are dividing by 10, what is the remainder? Ones, isn't it? What is the remainder? I told you, na, when we divide any number by 10, then the remainder is the digit at the ones place. So that is 8. So what is the quotient? Rest of the digit. What is the rest of the digits are? 63. See, already we got the answer. Now with the help of this, now we will solve this. 63. So I'll write here. Now I will start. 10 6 are 60. 3 minus 0 is 3. 6 minus 6 is 0. Now bring down 8. Now again 10 times 3 makes 30. So 8 minus 0 is 8. 3 minus 3 is 0. See, quotient is 63, remainder is 8. Clear? Understood, students? Is that clear? Now we will solve the next example. Second one. Okay? What is the second one? 4622 division by 10. Now 4 digit is given. Okay, so directly you can find out here quotient and the remainder. How students? See, whenever you are dividing with 10, so the remainder is digit at the ones place. What is digit at the ones place? Is 2, and the rest of the digits are quotient. 462. Now we will solve 4622 division by 10. So quotient is there already. So write quotient on the top and try with the same. 10 fours are 40. So 6 minus 0 is 6. 4 minus 4 is 0. Now bring down 2. Now 10, how many times? 6 times 10 makes 60. So write here 60, or 10 6 is 60. Now 2 minus 0 is 2, 6 minus 6 is 0. Now the bring down the next 2, 10 2 is 20. 2 minus 0 is 2, 2 minus 2 is 0. See, the remainder is 2, the quotient is 462. Clear? Understood? Yes. Now I will solve fifth one for you. What is the fifth one? 5032. 5032 divided by 100. See, just now we have seen division by 10. Now division by 100. See, quotient and the remainder. Can we? Yes, we can. See, try to recall your memory. What we have to do whenever we are doing the division by 100, the remainder will come, the digit at the ones place and the tens place. See, ones and tens, that is 32. So whatever remaining rest of the digit comes as a quotient, 50. Okay, now we will solve this example. 5032 division by 100. Write the quotient on the top, 50. Now 10 5 is 500, isn't it? Now 3 minus 0 is 3, 0 minus 0 is 0, 5 minus 5 is 0. Now the bring down 2. See, 32 is less than 100, so we cannot subtract. So in that time when we have bring down, we have to do something. So 100 zeros are, yes, 0. So what will remain? 32. Clear? Understood, students? Now cross check, your quotient is 50, the remainder is 32. Now we will solve seventh one example. What is the seventh one question? Division by 100. Very interesting question. Now quotient and the remainder. See, apply the same rule, students. What is the rule? When a number is divided by 100, the remainder made up by digit at the ones place and tens place, isn't it? Yes. 1's place, 10's place. What is there? 91. So what about quotient? Rest of the digit. Is any digit is there here? No. If nothing is there, means what is there? 0. Are you getting what I am trying to tell you? See, go with the same rules. Whenever we are doing division by 100, so we have to look at the digit at 1's and tens we have to write as a remainder, and the rest of the digit we have to write as a quotient, but nothing is there means 0 will be there. Now we will try here. This is dividend, 91 right side, and the divisor left side. Okay, now 100 goes from 91, students? No. So 100 zeros are 0. What will remain? 91 only. See, the quotient is 0, the remainder is 91. Is that clear? Clear students? Don't be confused. They will give such questions to confuse you. But use your tricks. Apply. It will make sum to solve easy. Now we will go with the next sum. Now we will start with 1000. Ninth one I will solve for you. What is the ninth one? See, 5030 division by 1000. We have seen 10 division by 10, division by 100. Now we are going to see the division by 1000. Try to recall your memory about the rules of 1000. When a number is divided by 1000, what will come? Remainder and the quotient. Yes. Tell me. Recall your memory, students. Yes. The remainder made up by digit in the hundreds place, tens place and ones place. What is there? 0, 3, 0. So, 0, 3, 0 means 0. 0 don't have any value. So, you can write directly 30. But we have to take till hundreds place. Otherwise, again you will make confuse here. Again, you will write 50. We have to take, whenever we are dividing with 1000, we have to take hundreds, tens and ones as a remainder. And the rest of the digit, what is the rest of the digit is 5. Write as a quotient. Now we will solve that sum. 5030 divided by 1000. Now see, already we have find out it the quotient, write quotient 5. 1000 multiplied by 5 is 5000. Do the subtraction. 0 minus 0 is 0, 3 minus 0 is 3, 0 minus 0 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. So what is the remainder? 30. Are you getting? 30. And the quotient is 5. Clear? Yes, very easy. Now I will solve another example. Now 10th one I will solve. 10th one they had given very interesting to confuse you, but you are not going to confuse. Yes. Now see, 780 division by 1000. Okay. Apply our rules. Find out the quotient and remainder by seeing the number only. See, whenever we are dividing by 1000, what remainder will come? Remainder is made up by digit in the hundreds, tens and ones. See, already they had given only hundreds, tens and one. So this three number will goes in remainder. So the rest of the digit will made up of quotient. But what is rest of the digit? Nothing is there. Nothing is there means what is there? Zero. So write zero. Now solve here. Write dividend on right side, divisor on left side. The quotient is zero. See, because we cannot subtract 1000 from 780. So in that case, we have to multiply with zero. 1000 multiplied 0 is 0 and write the answer. 0 minus 0, 0, 8, nothing is there. So write 8 as it is, 7 as it is. What is remainder? 780. Clear? Got it? Now last sum I will solve for you. Twelfth one. What is 12th one? 9052. 9052 division by 1000. Now apply our rules. Find out the quotient and remainder by using the tricks. Whenever you are dividing with 1000, the remainder is made up of 100, tens and ones. What is there? Hundreds place 0, tens place 5 and the remainder is 2. And the rest of the digits are made up of quotient. Write the 9. Remaining is 9. Now write here. 9052. Divisor is 1000. Okay. Now see. What is the quotient? Is 9. So write quotient as it is on the top. Now, how many times 1000 make 9000 9 times. So right, 1000 multiplied by 9 is 9000. Do the subtraction. 2 minus 0 is 2, 5 minus 0 is 5, 0 minus 0 is 0, 9 minus 0 is 0. Isn't it? Now see, quotient is 9, the remainder came 52. See here, 52 is there. 0, 5, 2. See, is there any value of this 0? No. We'll read 0, 52? No, only we read as a 52. Clear? Understood this sum? Yes. So today here we have completed our exercise 4.5. Okay, division by 10, 100 and 1000. Keep in your mind whatever tricks they had given whenever you are dividing with 10. What is the, we will revise once. What is the division by 10? What you have to see? Whenever you are doing division by 10, what remainder is made up of? Remainder is made up of digit at the ones place and the rest of the digits are quotient. What about division by 100? Yes, in 100, remainder is made up of digit at tens place and ones place and the rest of the digits are quotient. And what about division by 100? In that, the remainder is made up of digit at the hundreds place, hundreds place, tens place and ones place and the rest of the digits are quotient. If rest of the digits are there, that will come. If nothing is there, means zero will come. Keep in your mind these things. Okay. Now, here we will wind up our today's session. Today's your home assignment is remaining sums you are going to solve by your own in your rough book. Okay. Now, we will meet in our next session with the story sums in division. Till that time, take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.